Hello, I'm Simon Whistler, you're watching TopTenzNet, and in the video today, we're looking at the top 10 archaeological discoveries that we still don't get. Number 10. The Voynich Manuscript.
Okay, so in the Yale University Library, there's this mysterious document, right? And nobody can decode the writing, and it's in no writing system known to humans, we presume. The vellum on which the manuscript was written was once determined to be of 15th century origin. Naturally, we conclude that the document was created at that time. But not so fast, buddy. The manuscript, named after the book dealer who found this undecipherable text in 1912, has continued to stump cryptologists to this day. With the advent of the internet, professionals and amateurs exchange scores of information in an attempt to crack the code once and for all. The major question is, where did the document come from? Are we able to trace its ownership and or existence to one or more historical people? Not all who encounter the Voynich manuscript are convinced that the document is authentic. Some believe that Voynich himself had enough knowledge to create a false document, but nobody could make up an entire language and system of writing not known to man, right? Well, Dr. Mark Orkin did manage to create the Klingon language.
Number 9. The Stone Spheres of Costa Rica.
Designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site, the purpose of the stone spheres of Costa Rica continues to elude researchers. Locally known as Las Bolas, these perfectly round balls made from indigenous lava seemingly have no reason to be there. First rediscovered in various parts of the later 19th, early 20th century, all of the spheres predate the arrival of the Spanish. The speculation that many spheres were destroyed after the Spanish took over the area, leaving researchers with fewer clues than before. Dr. Sam Lathrop was one of the earlier archaeologists who studied the spheres in situ, who theorized that the stones had some connection to religion and astronomy. That's anthro-speak for I don't know. With much evidence gone due to the Spanish invasion of Costa Rica, will we ever find out?
Number 8. Cocaine and tobacco residue on mummies.
In 1992, it was reported that a team of German researchers found both cocaine and nicotine residue on Egyptian mummies as part of an ongoing study investigating the use of hallucinogenic substances in ancient societies. Nicotine and cocaine are plants that can only be found in the Americas, leading Dr. Balba Nova and her team to speculate that Egyptians had cross-cultural contact with people in the Americas. If so, would that mean that the Egyptians discovered the Western Hemisphere long before the Europeans? Detractors from this theory state that cross-contamination of the specimens were a logical explanation of the phenomenon.
Number 7. The Baltic Sea Anomaly.
Here we go with the aliens from outer space theory. A fossil found on the bottom of the Baltic Sea in 2011 is obviously a UFO that crashed on Earth. Because what else could it possibly be? Well, maybe a natural geographically formed object, perhaps. No. Life Science cites that Peter Lindbergh, the leader of the dive team claiming to have found this UFO, has failed to disclose the exact location of where the discovery was made. He has also provided contradictory evidence to support his claim and says he will reveal more in a planned documentary. However, Stockholm University's associate professor of geology, Volker Bruhert, states the anomaly is a piece of basaltic rock deposited in the location of a glacier.
Number 6. China's First Emperor's Pyramid and the Terracotta Army.
Looking for that perfect real estate for the afterlife? Are you looking for thousands of workmen to make your dreams become a reality? Do you need an army of soldiers and dozens of beautiful dancers to faithfully accompany you? Have we got a deal for you? The tomb of the first Chinese emperor, Qin Shi Huangdi, discovered in 1974, was declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The site was named upon the discovery of an army of soldiers made from terracotta clay, numbering in the thousands. Only 4 pits in this sprawling complex have been excavated so far, yet over 8,000 of these soldiers are estimated to exist. Despite the vast discoveries made, the tomb of the emperor himself has not been excavated. While underground chambers are thought to exist, archaeologists are refraining from opening the cavern due to concerns over disturbing the contents and environment within.
Number 5. Interlocking stones at Puma, Punku.
Although these ancient structures are not included in the list of the world's wonders, they are believed to be the oldest ruins on Earth's surface. They are located in Tiahuanaco, South America, and represent achievement that seems unattainable for the local population, Aymara Indians, during those ancient times. The stone structures amaze and confuse archaeologists who cannot explain how the separate stones have been created with the techniques for cutting existing in those days. Interlocking stones at Puma Punku are made of granite and diorite. An interesting fact about them is that only diamond is harder than these two minerals. If the people who built this place have made the stones themselves, they should have used diamond tools. One more intriguing fact about the stone structures is their weight, which exceeds 800 tons per stone. That is amazing, given that the nearest quarry is about 10 miles away. It is very difficult for even the most modern technology and equipment to fit and move such a heavy load.
Number 4. Shroud of Turin.
The Shroud of Turin is one of the world's most famous Christian relics. It is believed that the body of Jesus Christ had been wrapped in it when he was in the grave. The shroud provoked even greater interest in 1898, when, with the help of special tools, an image of a face was found on it. Now scientists are revealing interesting details about how, according to them, this mysterious image could appear. Some of the experts believe that the image has appeared as a result of strong radiation during an earthquake that happened in Old Jerusalem in 33 AD. They also think that the neutron radiation has affected carbon content in the fabric, which changed the results of the artifact's state of origin. The researchers explain that when the neutrons interact with nitrogen atoms, the result is the generation of protons. This can lead to the appearance of an image on the shroud. However, this is an unconfirmed theory and might be far away from the truth.
Number 3. The Great Pyramid of Giza.
Being one of the seven wonders of the world, the Great Pyramid in Giza is still attracting the attention of dozens of archaeologists, physicists, and astrologers who have worked for centuries and are still working today to unravel the truth and mysteries of this amazing monument. For the construction of the Great Pyramid of Giza, workers had to move and stack stone blocks of 6.5 million tons, some of which weighed up to 9 tons each. All that the workers would have had to perform this work would have been wood and ropes. According to the analysis, the stone blocks used to build the Sphinx temples have been taken from a moat that surrounds it on three sides. Many of these blocks, some of which weigh more than 100 tons, are so large that they could contain two or three different geological layers.
Number 2. Stonehenge.
Undoubtedly, Stonehenge is one of the most popular ancient monuments that presents a magnificent megalith composition that impresses visitors not only with its appearance, but also with its mystical past. The stone ruins of Stonehenge are located in the Salisbury Valley. It is believed that some of the rocks have been brought all the way from South Wales, although some of them weigh 4 tons. Most of the stones are equal in size and are grouped in pairs. On top of these pairs of stones, an equal stone is placed horizontally. An altar is situated in the center of the ancient monument, and the inner circle of two horseshoe-shaped structures is located around it. What exactly Stonehenge symbolizes and what the purpose of it is remains a mystery. There are three main theories, one of which supposes that this is a place for ritual ceremonies and funerals near a city of the dead, or probably a temple of the sun.
Number 1. Nazca Lines.
Nazca lines are called drawings and represent ancient lines drawn on the ground in the territory of Nazca Desert, Peru. They were discovered in 1927 and were the most extraordinary heritage left from a 2,000-year-old culture. These lines and figures represent a sequence of complex designs, some of which are many miles long and can be seen in their true dimensions only by plane. Experts exclude the possibility that the people in the ancient Nazca culture would have been able to fly, but the question of how these drawings were made, what kinds of technologies would have been used, and what their purpose is remains unknown. These lines are simple lines, triangles, spirals, and even more complex drawings of a spider, hummingbird, llama, monkey, fish, etc. The largest ones are 270 meters in length. They are located on 500 square kilometers in total. The lines were made by removing the reddish stones so the pale, nearly white soil underneath could appear.
So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up below and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, if you enjoyed this video, check out some of our other videos over there on the right. And thank you for watching.